Hello. I will show you today how to use the virtual expeditor for owned trailers. After the download of the 2.1 version, you have to extract it, extract to virtual expeditor folder. Then enter the folder and open the config CFG file. You have the fuel tank capacity line here, and you have to enter value for your tractor. It is important because if this value is not correct, then you can see wrongly the fuel usage on the summary screen. So my tractor is a MAN TGX. It has 1160 liters. And after entering this value here, you are saving the file and you are ready to start Speditor. Run the Speditor with the virtual Speditor.exe file. Start. You have to select the folder with your profile. Eurotrack profiles. Profile. I'm using always autosave as it always loads the latest data from the game. So press the load button. The profile is loading. If the profile is loaded correctly, you can see here the selection drop-down menus. We are choosing own trailer here. Trailer selector has automatically changed to cart and sider. You can select different trailer. This will filter the cargos. What is important is to select properly the map. What is available, it is ETS 135, ETS 136, promos 241 and 42, promos plus RAST map, promos plus Poland Rebuilding and Rus map on its own without promos. I will use ETS 136 because I have no promos at this profile. Then you are selecting the source. So I'm currently at Warsaw and let's take this Stokes, and for the short travel we will select the Warsaw again, and we will have the Pospet company. Here you have filtered cargos only for the Kurtensider. So let's take bottled water for example and press add and save. You have file saved information here, which mean the saving went properly and you can load the profile in your game. We are starting the Euro Truck Simulator at this moment. Okay, selecting the profile. What is important that when you're using the virtual expeditor, you have to have connected trailer. So go to trailer management, select the trailer, connect it physically to the tractor, and it have to be empty. Otherwise you won't be able to add the cargo. Now we can see that we have a bottled water from Warsaw to Warsaw here. So the cargo was added. Now, what is important? At this moment you are ready to go to load the cargo. However, on the world map you won't see the GPS route to the source company. There is a green flag on the map and you have to set the GPS on your own. It is not possible to set up it automatically here. So we are setting the road to Stokes. This is the green flag here. It is always the green flag for the starting point. And we can travel to the company so we can load the cargo. Okay, when we arrive to the company, we do not use the green icon to select the cargo. Cargo is pre-selected already and we have to park on the ramp to load the cargo. So we are not stopping at the green icon. We are supposed to maneuver to the spot where we need to load the cargo directly. This is the moment when the game starts working as usual with the virtual speditor. So we are loading the cargo. And you can see that map shows you the route to the proper destination. We don't have to do anything else at this moment, just to deliver the cargo. We are turning here, and here we have to stop at the icon and select the loading way of loading, if it is simple or hard, where to park it. We will play safe at this time. We are parking our trailer normally, as we are doing it with the own trailer. I'm always overshooting the point, but doesn't matter. Let's stop the engine and you press enter to unload. The cargo was delivered. Summary screen shows you the everything correct if you set the fuel capacity properly. You can check the fuel capacity for your tractor here in the diagnostic, and it is here the fuel tank. It's in liters, so just to you need to write down this value and re-enter it in the config file. Okay, thank you very much for your attention, and that's all. Goodbye.